have to be bashful in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and show the respect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then here, as we said, when we want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us everything good, and if we read in the Quran, it tells us, Istaghfirullah, innahu kana ghaffara, yursil sama' alaykum midrara. When we say Istaghfirullah, He will give us money and He will solve our problems and give our children everything just for His istighfar. And at-taqwa is the same thing. So we have to realize, and yet they taught us there's always a but. I don't know where they got this but from. And I got an email from somebody the other day dealing with this issue. He said, a man who worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was praying and he's crying, a lot of tears coming from him. And a crazy man talked to him after the prayer saying, why are you crying, brother? He said, I'm crying for the fear of Allah. The man, the good man, is praying and crying from the fear of Allah. So the crazy man looked at him and laughed at him. So he said, why are you laughing at me? He said, how could you be crying from the fear of Allah when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called himself al-ghafoor al-raheem, the forgiving, the merciful? Why are you always thinking that even in the prayer that Allah is going to punish you, rather than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to forgive you and have mercy on you? He said, I'm laughing all the time because my God is forgiving and merciful. And you're crying all the time because your God is going to punish you and burn you all the time. Subhanallah. And then the crazy man walked away and he said, I don't know who's crazy, me or him. Because he said he makes a sense. Huh? And that's why he's laughing and smiling all the time, because he knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafoor raheem. Allah is ghafoor raheem. And if we realize this, we'll be smiling. And we have husnul zann billah, good hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as Imam al-Shafi'i said in a poem, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to punish us, would He have taught us at-tawheed? Would He have taught us la ilaha illallah? He taught us this so He doesn't punish us. And yet, we only want to focus on the punishment rather than focus that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafoor raheem. So inshallah, when we go into prayer, we leave a dunya behind us and think, when we are doing sujood, we are doing sujood in front of Allah. We are in the presence of Allah, and it will give our prayers a different meaning altogether. And then we will not worry about a dunya. And if we have a problem in a dunya while in sujood, where we are very close to Allah, ask Him to solve it. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ask and I will answer. وَأَذَرْ سَيَسَلْ وَسَأَلَكَ عَبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبُ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. I am close and answer the prayers of those who ask. And we are the closest in Allah in this sujood. So rather than our mind being somewhere else, we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us with these problems and make our nafs mutma'innah, restful soul, that we can focus on our prayers inshallah and don't worry about the dunya, because inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will solve it all for us. Allahumma ahdina ya maulana fi man hadayt, wa aafina fi man aafayt, wa qina wasrif anna sharr ma qadayt. Allahumma barik lana fi ma aatayt. اللهم انك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم لا تجعل لنا في جمعنا هذا ذنبا الا غفرته، ولا مريضا الا شفيته، ولا هما الا فرجته، ولا دينا الا قضيته، ولا حاجه لنا في هذه الدنيا لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح الا قضيتها يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات، الاحياء منهم والاموات، اللهم اغفر لنا ولاخواننا الذين سبقونا بالايمان، ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين امنوا، ربنا انك رؤوف رحيم. ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قرة اعين، واجعلنا المتقين اماما. عباد الله، ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى، وانهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي، يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم، واستغفروه يغفر لكم، واقم الصلاه.